And from here on, I'm going to continue my life in English. So all of you who are asking questions in English, from here on, I'll be replying back to your questions. I welcome all my international patients over here, all my national patients who are to chat with me live. So let's start with the questions now.
So one.
Vikramjit Singh, you are asking, can you take a pinch of salt in your food? Please give me your patient code, your details also. This is a question coming from Rishpusht, as I all explained to you. Rishpusht is a channel where the number of questions are comparatively less. So if you are feeling that your question is not answered, kindly post your question through Rishpusht. The name of channel is Rashtpusht. Please type it down for everyone to know this. Rashtpusht. And please ask the questions, bro.
So Vijay Lakshmiji's baby girl is 5 years old and she's on steroids. Would our treatment will helpful for get out of the nephrotic syndrome?
Vijay Lakshmiji, first of all, I would like to tell you, when it comes to nephrotic syndrome, it is known as pathic prameha in Ayurveda. And if I talk about nephrotic syndrome children, the youngest child in which I gave a medicine for nephrotic syndrome was less than 3 months old. He was from Abu Dhabi. By the grace of Almighty, he is perfectly well now. And when it comes to nephrotic syndrome, definitely Ayurveda has a lot in scope. The omnocotyl or tacrolimus or any kind of medicines that are being given in allopathy, when we start Ayurvedic treatment in a patient suffering from nephrotic syndrome, initially we carry on with the medicines that are being given in allopathy to the child. And then gradually, as the 24-hour urinary protein goes on decreasing, then we gradually taper down the dosage. So yes, nephrotic syndrome, definitely Ayurveda has a lot of scope for the patients of nephrotic syndrome. Yes, the next question.
So Mr. Mustafa Zaki, he is taking our medicines of CKD, 7 type of medicines at the age of 76. So can he allopathy will be taken simultaneously, do any side effect?
Mr. Mustafa, do not count the number of tablets. I can understand that with the number of tablets that we give to our patients in today's world, when the patients are in the habit of taking allopathic medicines, when the number of tablets are much more in Ayurveda, a person tends to worry that the number of tablets is so much. It may not cause any problem to me, but I can assure you that all their medicines are herbal. And as far as allopathic medicines are concerned, once you improve to a good extent with the help of our medicines, we surely will be reducing the number of medicines that are being given to you. Dr. Rajiv, please don't miss out on the questions of Facebook. If there is any question, you can ask me the question.
So one question is from Facebook. Subhijit, he's asking for any treatment for cancer.
Subhijit ji, you have asked your question from Facebook. We welcome your question. See, there are a lot many things that can be done for a cancer patients in Ayurveda. But to be honest, what I personally believe is that if we are live, it is not for minting out money or for selling of any medicines. We really want to guide you in a proper way. So my request to you will be either through my channel Dr. Navdeep Sharma or through my channel Rishpusht, you can leave your question with your number. Let my team connect to you so that they can see that what exactly is the stage of the cancer, where is the metastasis, what is the condition of the patient. There are a lot many things that need to be known before we can commit you something. So we can definitely try. My request over here for you will be that leave your number through one of our channels. In case you are unable to leave it through our channel, you can leave it here at Facebook also. Yes, Gauravji.
So Rajendraji is asking, please tell me one ELISA is equal to how many CMIA?
Rajendraji, unluckily there is not a correlation that we can make. See, what happens is at times the patient, they get tested it by ACLIA method, at time with ELISA, at time with CMIA. All three are different methods, and the irony of the thing is we cannot compare one method with another. So my request is, if you are taking treatment from us or from anywhere else, and if you have been committed that yes, you can improve, go for one type of test. Do not go for separate methods of test. Only one method of test can be compared with another method of the same method, not with the different method. Yes.
Neelam Athwalji wants appointment with you, sir.
Neelamji, please share your location. And my most common location is Chandigarh, where I generally try to visit. If I am in India, if I'm not on an international travel, I try visiting in Chandigarh on Tuesdays. Tomorrow again, I'll be available over here for my OPDs. But if I am in my international travels, then I am not available in Chandigarh. There are other locations also where at times I do go for my OPDs. Please share your location. You can leave your number. My team will get in touch with you to see that which is the most nearest OPD where we can connect to you. Yes.
Mr. Mustafa Jaki, do we have recommended food chart for CKD patients?
Mr. Mustafa, see, if I talk about the exact food, you can say diet chart, where milligrams and all are mentioned, I will say no. But if I talk about food recommendations, what are good for a kidney patient, right in the beginning of this video, I gave full details of that. It is in Hindi. If you have any questions in English related to it, you can always ask me the same. Because to be honest, people from different countries, they join us on this live. When it comes to the questions which they generally ask for us, if moong ki dal, it said moong ki dal over here, it is termed at something different in a different country, the third name in a different country, Physalius moongo, that is the botanical name which I am aware of. But then, what is the vernacular name at a particular location? It is different from different places. So what I would like over here is, you can ask your questions about your diet, about a particular thing, that whether this thing can be taken or not. And I would love to reply you back about a particular thing, whether it can be taken or not. Mr. Bhatt, you have mentioned about your patient ID. It is 335411. And the creatinine level is 5.5. Kinu, you have asked whether he is allowed to take kinu. I would say that kinu, since they are rich in potassium, avoid giving kinu to him. Citrus fruits are to be avoided. Again, I would request all my existing patients, the questions which are there on wrist pushed are easier for me to take for my existing patients. So if you are having a question in your mind and you are my existing patient, my genuine request to you, you can also post your question at wrist pushed, where it becomes easier for me to segregate whether this is a question from my existing patient and this is a question from my new patient. Yes, Gaurav ji.
Sumant Kumar, his elder brother is having the kidney problem and creatinine is 7.66 and urea is 151, but dialysis not had started. So please guide further.
Mr. Kumar, it's very good that you have not started the dialysis as yet. See, if right now he's not facing any major medical problem like breathlessness, vomiting and all, definitely with the help of Ayurveda, we can expect a lot to be done. What is required over here is a thorough analysis and then we can start with the things. You can leave your number over here immediately after this live of mine. Either Ms. Palak or Gaurav Kataria will be getting in connection with you and they will give you the complete details. And do not worry, if we take necessary quick actions right now, we can definitely expect to avoid dialysis in your brother's case. So do not worry, a lot can be done till now. Yes.
So Mr. Vikramji from Rishth Pushth, 343855. Today ECG was done and I was prescribed tab Alprex by doctor. Can I take it?
See, if ECG was done and tablet Alprex was prescribed, what I personally feel is Alprex is generally prescribed to a patient when there is palpitations and the pulse rate of the patient is more. What I personally suggested, do not develop a habit of taking it regularly. If your pulse rate is above 90, you are feeling a lot of, you can say, restlessness and all, then you can take it. Do not develop a habit of taking it daily. Vikramjit ji, you are asking that can I take a bowl of moong dal in diet? Yeah, definitely you can take a bowl of moong dal in diet. There is no problems about it. Yes.
So Mr. Habir is asking, his patient ID is 355411 and the creatinine is 5.1. Can he take kinu?
No, Mr. Habir. I just asked, no kinus. Avoid kinus. Citrus fruits are to be avoided a bit. Yes. Dhiraj ji, you have asked that you did a fibro scan on same day and three reports were different, like 34 kPa, 29 kPa and 15 kPa. And allopathy says it can't be reversed. But you say it is reversible. Please answer. See, Mr. Dhiraj, when we talk about fibro scan, see, you have got three different fibro scan results. And if I talk about the first fibro scan result, it is the most alarming one. As I say, in Ayurveda, every treatment starts with Jatravani and Dhatravani. So there are so many medicines, so many good ones for liver disorders in Ayurveda. See, if I commit something over here, people will say that I am medically committing something. It's better that let the reports speak for us. Rather than me saying it, thus yes, it can be done. You can check the fibro scan. And then you can ask someone that, see, this was the fibro scan earlier on and this is now. Definitely with the help of Ayurveda, there are lot many patients who recover in this thing. Yes.
So Devan Paul is a hepatitis B patient from last 1.5
years. Just a minute, Mr. Vedant Jani, you are asking about hypothyroidism with high TSH levels, high prolactin levels and hypogonadism. See, if we talk about The recommended lifestyle in your case, the best is Kapalabhati. Do the maximum of Kapalabhati. It is very good for you. Another thing which is very good for you is Piper Longam. Piper Longam, which is also known as Magen, is one of the best things. So you can take Piper Longam, you can do Kapalabhati. You can also leave your contact details where our team can guide you. Chaturbij again is very good for you. Try taking more of Chaturbij. Chaturbij will really help you out a lot in improving. Yes, Mr. Gaurav.
So Mr. Divan, Paul, hepatitis B positive from last 1.5 years, and antigen is 0.40, antibody is 0.020, and HPSA quantity CMI is 7428. What is the position?
See, if I talk about the antigen level, which is 0.40, and CMI is 7428, Mr. Dipal, these two are a bit of different kind of tests. If the antigen level is so less, 0.40, the CMI level should not be that much. Please help me out with your reports. I would like to go through your reports. Dr. Kapil, you need to go through complete reports of Mr. Paul and then discuss the case with me and get back to him. Mr. Paul, give us some time. Let me see and compare the results. Mr. Shailata Swarna, please, again, you can post your question. Actually, their questions are missing out because number of questions are too much and then they are missed out. And you can also post your question on Rich Push channel. Dikshita ji, your question is that your dad's platinum clearance test is 45, output is 1500, and he is getting burns in his throat and he is taking Rantac allopathic medicine. Sir, can you please give us a remedy for burns? See, for burns, Dikshita ji, you can, if you want to go for any of our medicines, you can go for Endozyme syrup instead of Rantac. If you want to go for a natural thing, you can give a bit of soda bicarbonate in the morning, a bit of soda bicarbonate in the evening. Both are very good for him. As far as the creatinine clearance is concerned, it is good creatinine clearance. So all that we need to add on is either Endozyme. If he prefers going for tablets, you can add SCK tablets. They contain patol patra in them and they are very good in fighting with hypoacidity and sore eructations and belching and all. So you can give that also. They are very safe for kidney patients to be given. Yes, Mr.
So, General Ji, good evening, Doctor. My nephew has got few lumps in the throat, but it's not painful. Can you please advise what you think of it? Can we treat it?
See, if the lumps are there in the throat and which are non-painful, I don't feel that you need to take major medicines for him. All that is required is you can start with Kachanar Gugul. Kachanar Gugul is a very good combination for any kind of lumps. But what is important over here is that why those lumps have developed. So there are certain history, certain details which I would like to have. For example, whether he is getting any evening fever or not, whether he is losing any weight or not. There are certain questions which are very important. So please, if you can leave any contact details where one of my doctors can connect to you, then go for the detailed history of those lumps. If there is nothing much, then Kachanar Gugul should be in itself sufficient for fighting out those lumps. Yes.
So Mr. Shivshankar Sani is an existing patient. HPSA is positive and from October and 0.54 CMIA. Treatment is running. What is my position on how much time it will recover?
If it's 0.54 CMIA, it's very less CMIA. That means we are already on the borderline of being positive and negative. So you are on a borderline of becoming negative. It is very near to be bidding goodbye to this virus. So the position is very good. Do not worry. Do pranayams regularly. Take care of your diet. That is something which is really important. So do keep that thing in mind. Yes.
Mr. Sheikh, yes, sir, that you have written one tablet from outside which I have to take two mouth regular and six tablet per day or what I can cut out my food. So I can eat those medicine with this medicine.
Mr. What I can cut out on?
I think it was not clear so that I can...
Your question is not very clear to us, Mr. Sheikh. You can leave your patient ID, Dr. Kapil, immediately after this live. We'll get in connection to you to take a thorough understanding of what exactly is the help which you want from us. And then we can guide you in a better way in this regards. Yes.
So Mr. Vedant is hypothyroidism with high TSH levels, high prolactin levels and...
I just took the question of Mr. Vedant. Yeah.
So can HPSAG be negative?
Mr. Ashu Gupta ji, sir, my father has kidney transplant, but the creatinine level is always fluctuating. Mr. Ashu, see, if he is a patient of transplanted kidney, if there is a bit of fluctuation, say the creatinine level is going till 2.1, 1.4, 1.6, do not worry. But if it is going higher than that, then do forward us the details because If the creatinine level goes above 3.0, then it means that the transplanted kidney is not being accepted in that way by the body. So it is there that it becomes important that yes, something needs to be done, which can be with the help of Ayurveda also. So please help us out with further details in his case. Yes.
So Mr. Nagaraju, polycystic kidney disease and creatinine 2.9 and urea 64.
Just a minute, Mr. Suraj Mohra, you are telling that the creatinine level is 8.19 and the urea is 102. We are getting your medicines from approximately 10 days. Can we make a dialysis because patient is suffering from stomach pain? See, if he has not gone for a dialysis till now ever, one thing which I would like to know here is that you have mentioned that the urea is 102. The thing which is important over is it may be BUN which is 102, that is blood urea nitrogen. If the BUN is 102, that is the blood urea nitrogen is 102, you need to approximately multiply it with 2, and then that means that the blood urea is around 204. So if it's BUN 102, then you can go for a dialysis. If the blood urea is only 102, then I don't feel that it entirely depends upon what is the condition of the patient and how he is feeling. Your patient code over here with us, I will again request Dr. Kapil, he shall be connecting to you after this live of mine to take further details about your patient. And then we will decide and we will be guiding you whether dialysis is required or it can be avoided. Yes.
So patient ID is 327506, serum creatinine is 2.4 and getting backbone pain, 3 weeks gone. Please advise me, I need medicine. Please provide some discount.
See, as far as discounts are concerned, I always guide my patients. Any help, any support you require from us, you are always welcome at the Chandigarh Center. See, we can help you out at particular places. So if anyone is having any severe financial concerns, we are there to help out those financially, people who are facing financial problems here at our Chandigarh Center. And if you have been blessed with good finances, then do not expect discounts. Expect a good treatment. So if any one of you who is taking treatment from us is facing financial crunch, is having any kind of financial problem, visit Chandigarh Center. And if you are blessed with good finances, then let us help all those who are not that blessed. What I can promise you over here is that yes, if someone is really facing any financial problems, we will definitely help him. But do make sure, let someone who is not privileged be blessed with that help. If you can, always go for the best of medicines. And what was the other question apart from the that?
So Ashu Gupta is
his first part of the question. The question which you just asked me.
The serum creatinine is 2.4 and getting backbone pain.
Another thing, for your backbone pain, you need to have some ajwain in a, you can say, cloth. You have to do the fomentation of that ajwain on your back. It will reduce the pain also, as well as at the same time it is good for your kidneys also. So ajwain fomentation to be done at your back, it is very good for you. Yes.
So Ashu Gupta, his father is a kidney transplant, but there is a fluctuation in the creatinine level.
Yeah, we took the question of Mr. Ashu just recently. Santosh Mishra ji has asked a question that my father is taking allopathic medicine together with your medicine, but he complains loose motion. So can we stop allopathic medicines or we continue together? Mr. Santosh, if Punarnavadi Mandur is being given in our medicine, you can stop Punarnavadi Mandur out of your medicines. And as far as allopathy is concerned, if any potassium binder is being given, K bind sachets and all, if the potassium level is normal, you can reduce that. Because at times it also causes loose motion if there is any iron supplement that is being given. Because generally when a patient is suffering from kidney problem, iron supplements are given to the patient. So it may cause loose motion. So please help us out with the details. Your ID is here with us already. Dr. Kapil, don't forget to note down the ID. You have to take complete details after this. Yes.
So Mr. Essel is Dr.
Mr. Santosh Mishra is asking that last time also we didn't reply back to his question. Mr. Mishra, I would request you to again post your question, because in so many questions, your question is not visible to me in front. Please help me out with your question once again. I'll definitely take your question.
Yes. Mr. Santosh Mishra is asking, sir, his patient ID is 340874. Then my father is taking allopathy medicine together with your medicine, but he complains loose motion. So that
I just took the question of Mr. Santosh.
So Mr. Asil is there, sir. Doctor, can my mother has a cyst in liver? Can you recommend some any medicines?
Mr. Asil, see if she's having a cyst in her liver. Kachana or Gubul, as I just told, is very good. Another good medicine is SL Care. SL Care is an Ayurvedic combination which is very good for liver cyst and liver infection. So you can give SL Care also to her. And you can also forward her ultrasound scan to us. All that you need to do is on Google Play Store, we are having our mobile app on the name of ND Care. So ND Care app you can download from Android Store and then you can forward the ultrasound scan. Automatically when you download that, you can say app, you get a patient code. So through that patient code, you can forward your reports. Our doctors will analyze the reports. Until that time, you can take SL Care tablets. Yes.
So Sumit, our patient ID is 342237. How can we manage water in kidney patient as there are lot many Ayurvedic and allopathy medicines has to be taken?
Mr. Sumit, that really is a very good question, and generally people are having a problem taking so many medicines. First of all, take all the medicines collectively. Generally what people feel is that the allopathic and Ayurvedic medicines are not to be taken together, and that is what they are guided by many doctors. But what is important over here is that they can be taken collectively. So try taking both of them collectively so that you save on the water. And if you are taking our medicine, there is a medicine known as Nephrosep for Punarnavadi Arkh, which is just like water. So you can take your medicine with it also. You can add a bit of water in it and take the medicines with it. That will also cut down on the water intake that is being taken. Yes.
Sir, I missed one question. There is Nagaraju polycystic kidney disease, 2.9 creatinine and urea 6.4.
Mr. Nagarajuji, despite having a polycystic kidney disease, it is good that the creatinine and the urea levels have not gone out of bound. So there is a lot that can be done with the help of Ayurveda. Because what happens is at times the patients, they approach us at such an advanced age that we in ourselves are not knowing whether at this stage, for example, if a patient is approaching us at a creatinine level of 14 and a blood urea level of 250, and now the patient wants treatment from us in a polycystic kidney disease, we will say firstly go for a dialysis and then start our treatment. But in patients like you, it becomes easier for us. We know that our target is reducing the cysts and giving a bit of kidney supplements. So in patients like you, a lot many things can be done. Yes.
So Kalpana Kunala is the patient ID is 338498. CBP blood test is hemoglobin is 10.2%, RBC 3.6 and packed cell volume is 3%. The question.
Your patient ID is here with us. You have shared your reports. Your reports are important with us also. Dr. Kapil will again be getting back to you after this live of mine to take further details. He will analyze your previous reports also so that we can exactly know that what needs to be changed or whether the medicines need to be continued. So give us some time. Dr. Kapil, make sure that you give a call to her. All of you who will be getting calls, do remember that when Dr. Kapil will be giving you calls, the number through which you will get a call most probably will be 0172-51-0052. At times, since we all have installed Truecaller, the number may show you that it's a spam call. The reason for that is there are thousands of calls which come to us. When we don't answer, at times people spam our calls, and we also give outbound calls to patients. So the call will definitely come to you. Don't miss the call. Do make sure that you take that call. Yeah.
So Suresh Kumar, 338498, and courage count, the question is incomplete, sir.
Mr. Suresh, I can't understand your question exactly. And Mr. Hemant Kumar, HBSAG, yeah, if we talk about HBSAG, it is possible. But then, what is the exact value of HBSAG right now? That also is important, whether the patient can follow our guidelines. That again is very important to us. Mr. J. Portkaji, you can exactly write this number of yours in addition to this question of yours. Here in itself, in this chat, you can write down your number will come to us, and we shall be connecting to you. And from my end, for my Facebook viewers, for my Twitter viewers, for my Instagram viewers, thank you all for joining us today, and bye-bye from my end. And for all of you who are over here, Mr. J. Portkaji, you can share your number over here. We shall be waiting for your number. You can immediately type your number over here and you can share your number over here. So thank you all of you. Thanks a lot for joining us today.